What is up, you, my fellow? What's up, guys? I don't know what to call you guys. I don't know if you want to be called something disrespectful. I don't know if you're into that kinky shit, but I know, you know what I'm into? Chest day. Chest fucking day, man. I'm fucking hyped. Late night lift at, well, I guess not as per usual anymore. I'm kind of always, you know, lifting at different times now, but my home is late night lifts. I love a late night lift. I love the feeling of a late night lift. I love everything about, I love everything about getting to the gym late, being one of the only 7 people in there, being able to fucking push myself as hard as possible without people judging me, you know, all of that stuff is stuff that I love about being at the gym. And my camera has a little weird setting going on to it right now. I'm not exactly sure what's going on, but hopefully it's fine in the actual gym. Oh, my fucking lens, bro. I don't understand. Looks like there's something on my lens. I think there was something on my lens. I think it looks better now. Whatever, we'll see. But, like I said, chest day. Great day to fucking start off with the pec deck, man. I would hope no one's on it. It's not crazy late. It's just after work, so if you know what time I get off work, then that's what time it is. But it's nothing fucking insane about, you know, what time I'm, you know, heading there right now. So it's not like I'm going to be fucking, you know, dead tired tomorrow, because I do have a haircut in the morning, and tomorrow is Savannah State Championship. I'm thinking about doing a vlog for that, but I also don't know. I don't know. I mean, we'll see. I don't know. We'll see. But yeah, I have a haircut tomorrow morning. Savannah's game tomorrow night, which I'm fucking excited for. And that's about it for tomorrow. I mean, there's a fine line between having a busy day than having a productive day, right? Like, you could have a productive day and it feels busy even though it wasn't. Like, you could get 4 things done that take a long time and it would feel like it was, like, very busy, but in reality it wasn't that busy. You did 4 things, right? But it was productive. And that's kind of the same kind of mindset that that you guys should have when going to the gym, right? Like, you're not going to be guaranteed to have a fucking super high volume hella sets fucking lift every day, right? But what you can do is you can get that fucking I feel like it's not focusing on me. Am I wrong? Let me zoom in. I feel like, dude, am I tripping or do I look transparent? Ah, whatever. We'll fix it in the gym. But what I was saying is having that mindset of consistency and finding ways to just, you know, get as much work in as often as possible, even if, right, like, even if there's not that many fucking opportunities to actually do it, like, even if it takes, like, you know, 6-7 sets, and you're fully fucking like, damn, I can't do any fucking more, that's fine, bro. 6-7 sets is not a pussy number of sets. There's no right or wrong number of sets to do for each workout. There isn't. Like, you can do whatever number of sets works for you. And that doesn't mean that it has to be a high volume. Like, if you can go and do 7 sets of whatever fucking muscle hit, of whatever muscle group you want to hit, and be done, man, good for fucking you. By the way, today's gonna be a little bit more than just chest. It's gonna be chest and shoulders. I'm gonna throw my front delts and side delts since I didn't do front delts yesterday. Rear delts are always tomorrow with back day, so that'll be then. But for now, we will be focusing on, you know, the chest portion, and there's traffic. Oh God, man. Why is there traffic this late at night right now? That shit makes no sense to me. None. Absolutely none. Well, why do they have to close these lanes off if they're already closing off certain okay, let me explain what's happening right now. Dude, no, yeah, my face is fucked. Why is it like that? Now it's good. Hold on. Hold on. I think I know what it is. I think I know what it fucking is. Is that it? I think it's just like face focused, so when I'm not looking at it, it's... Hold on. Figured it out. My camera was in manual exposure instead of auto exposure. So it was relying on my dumbass to set everything. The only reason reason I just did that right there is because I was pulled over on the side of the freeway, and there was no way niggas were gonna let me in, especially at this time of night. So had to speed up a little bit to get in. But I don't even know what I was saying now because I just got so fucking distracted on my damn camera. Why it looked like that, but it's okay. We'll figure it out. Paloma just sent me something on Instagram. That's the first time Paloma has ever sent me something on Instagram. This is a momentous occasion, guys. We have to celebrate this like it's the end of the fucking world. But I think I've done enough talking, so I really didn't even need to turn the fucking camera back on. I kind of just wanted to make sure I address you guys after the whole situation that just went on. So, yeah, that's why I did that. But let's get in there, warm up with some peck deck. Maybe I'll show, maybe I won't. Maybe I'll have something to yap about. Maybe I won't. We'll see. And then we'll get into our first pressing movement, which will be... I think I'm feeling some dumbbell incline today for our first pressing movement, but we'll see. I think I'm a Larson press today too, but who knows? Who fucking knows?
They both felt pretty good, but I kind of, I don't know.
I feel like you play 60
but I'm
a little bit strong today. But we're going to film our first working sense of failure with the 60 and see how it goes. The 40s and 50s were both just 2 sets to 8. I also did some tricep extensions, a little bit of shoulder rotations just to open up my shoulder and make sure it's not a lot of pain on these heavy presses. But I think, well, I don't know, but I have a round perfect at least, and maybe not exactly.
Okay. Oh, fuck.
We're gonna start the pec deck out with 150.
I was thinking about the front deck movement I want to do. I think I want to do cable front raises. Usually I do a pressing movement. I was gonna do dumbbell press, but I think that some cable front raises might be interesting movements to do. I haven't really done them that often, so
And we're always talking about, you know, switching it up and, you know, I'm always the one talking about switching it up and doing different things depending on, you know, what muscle I'm trying to hit. So only doing pressing movements for my front delts is, I mean, I do some of the fucking, you know, incline stuff does get a lot of front delt relaxation, but I will say the dumbbell stuff usually gets the least amount. You can really isolate my chest when you dumbbell incline, so it wasn't a lot of front delt. There was a little, but we'll focus more on it when we get to the or whatever we end up doing. But 3 sets of prep deck, 2 working sets, 1 drop set. Should be good. Probably with the shirt on, but already. See how it looks with the shirt off. Yeah. I'm kind of excited. Kind of feel like it's gonna be a pretty good one. Pretty good one. Tell me, bro. I think I'm pretty good. But the chest bump's got to good as a fucking shoulders. Some vert raises and some lat raises.
I'm using a rope. So I'm using a rope attachment for the vert raises. I like using the rope more than the straight bar because I feel like with the straight bar, my range of motion is super limited. So I can't really get much of it. Near the top, and plus the hand placement, I feel like here I'm not really getting as much frontal activation as I am when I'm here, so I think it's all around the rope feels better for me.
Now, I never really show these, but I always talk about how I do them. So I always start with one set of 50. Just do 8 reps just to warm up. Alright, and then we'll drop it to, and then what I'll do is I'll drop it to 40. I'm going to do a stall hold that I always talk about. So what I'm going to do here is I'm going to raise it. I'm going to raise it. So I'm going to go here, hold the left, do 5. Hold the right, do 5. Left, do 5. Right, do 5. Well, I guess hold the right, left, do 5 first because the left is a little bit weaker. So it's kind of just the reason I do the static holds is to kind of make sure that they're super balanced because at the same time, you can end up lifting a little bit more with one, the other one can fall behind. So if you can really rely on one foot, one side of your delts. So if you really want to work on your, I guess, equality and balance between the size and strength of your side delts, do these static raises. Timer's up, so what we'll do is I'm gonna... Of each is perfect because that means that the balance is getting there. And as you guys saw, those last 5 with the left were a lot slower than the last 5 with the right, but holding at the end is what really keeps it engaged while you're doing the ones with the right. So do one more like that, and then we'll do 2 just regular raising. Ugh. Not two more, just straight up. Okay. One more, but we're gonna put it up to, well, one higher. Hey. Forget the car. We're done. That, honestly, was probably easily the most efficient lift I've ever had in my life. I mean, I did my sets. I found the right weight. Did two fucking working sets to fucking failure on all of them. Well, not two. Some of them I did three, and I think one of them I did four, but that's not the point. The point is that that was a very, very efficient workout. That just goes to show you that all you people that are that make the, not all you people, but all the people that make excuses about not being able to make it to the gym as a time thing, makes no sense. That was an hour lift. I hit chest, front, and side delts in 1 hour. Like, if that doesn't show you that you can fucking hit these lifts in not a lot of time, I'm not really sure what will, bro. I'm not really freaking sure what will, because to be honest, that's the most important part of hitting the lifts, is being efficient with them. Because if you're doing these lifts right and you're, you know, lagging behind, spending 10 minutes on your phone between sets, you know, letting I mean, you can yap, right? You can talk to people, that's fine, but doing it to the point where it's fucking, you know, it's fucking like catching, biting you in the ass, that's what's gonna get you fucking, that's what's gonna mess up your pump, that's what's gonna mess up your lift, that's gonna be the reason your fucking your lifts take so long, man. That's gonna be the reason they take so long, because if you're trying, can't type Chipotle. If you're trying to hit these lifts with efficiency and consistency and make them, you know, part of your daily routine, and you're spending time throughout the lift yapping and scrolling on TikTok or on Instagram, looking at ass or gym baddies or whatever it is you fucking people look at while you're at the gym, bro, you're not gonna get the results you want, because at the end of the day, being locked in the gym is one of the most important parts of going to the gym, right? Like, you can have days where, you know, you're freaking falling behind, you have a horrible day, but you go to the gym and you lock in for that 45 to an hour, 30 minutes, and you're just all over it, man. You're just all freaking over it. And to be honest, if that's your thing, if you can do that and you can make all that shit happen, you know, every time you go to the gym, then I'm impressed, bro, because even I can't be fully fucking locked in every time I go to the gym. Even I struggle with, you know, maintaining my fucking consistency in terms of how locked in I was. But to be honest, it's like one of those things where if you see something that really reminds you of, hey, man, I gotta fucking lock in here. Like, today, I was listening to my Spotify playlist, my depressing one, and one of the songs came on, and it just made me fucking click. That second set of flat dumbbell press, that was where it clicked. I don't know if you guys can tell. The first few sets of incline dumbbell were good, but I think I could have maybe done a few more reps, which obviously I'm going to look back on it when I edit the video and see where my form was, how all that stuff looked, because the original reason I was recording all these videos was to just check my form, but it ended up becoming, you know, more than that. I started posting them because, you know, why not? If I can show you guys a thing or two while I'm teaching myself, then, you know, why not be there to support the people and be there for the people, man? One of the things that people always ask me about in terms of just, you know, like my friends and, not my friends, but like Savannah's friends, to be honest, they're always like, oh, put me in a video, oh, play me in this, oh, do this, oh, do that, blah, blah, blah. Like, bro, like, yeah, I'll do all that stuff. I don't mind. I'll make whatever kind of video I want, but at the end of the day, it's my channel. I'm going to make the kind of content I want to make. Like, my content is damn near all over the place sometimes, because you guys have seen, it's fucking basketball reactions, football reactions, video games, gym videos, vlogs, Q&A, it's fucking everything. It's everything. So being a, or taking part in a channel where you post where you want to post, and that kind of goes for anything that you want to do in life, right? Like, if you want to be freaking, you know, if you want to be freaking consistent and build up a reputation or start doing something that you know you want to do, that's gonna make you happy and you're gonna enjoy, don't let it be a hindrance or affect, like, don't do what other people do just because it works for them. Like, it's gonna depend on what you want to do and what you like to do, bro, because not everything is gonna be all sweet roses, and you're not gonna enjoy making some of the kinds of videos that other people would enjoy making. Like, there's videos that a lot of successful people make that I don't want to make, and the kind of videos that I don't want to make because I'm not going to enjoy making them. I'm not going to enjoy editing them. I'm not going to enjoy, posting them or feel like they're a good representation of me, because, to be honest, this whole channel is about representing myself and being able to just put myself out there and let people see what I do every day and how I act and, like, who I really am, because it's hard for me to open up to people, to be honest. It really is. But if I can open up to, myself and to the camera and then post it for people to see, that can be my way of opening up, man. It's slowly teaching me how to become, a version of myself that I never thought I could be, in terms of sharing things about my life and explaining what I do throughout these things and seeing if I can be a good coach for certain things. And, all these other things that I never really thought that I could, that I would be able to do in terms of my life in general. There's a lot of, going to the gym every day was not something I could have pictured myself doing 3 months ago, 4 months ago. But now it's just a part of my routine. I can't not go to the gym. If I don't go to the gym, I can't even imagine it. I really can't. So, I guess it's all about perspective at the end of the day and what you really want to do. But I really enjoy going to the gym. I love recording it. I love talking to you guys. I love, explaining all the stuff that I do and just being myself, because if I'm going to be fully transparent, there's not a lot of people that I can be myself around. There's not a lot of people that I feel comfortable enough to talk like this to. But to the camera and to myself, I don't have a single freaking problem with it. I can talk to you and talk to the camera all freaking day about whatever it was, but it really just comes down to, just having an outlet. Like, finding an outlet and finding a way to be able to let out the parts of me that I don't let out in the regular day. Now, at the gym, that's what it is. All those sets to failure, all those pushing myself, all those last fucking struggling reps that I'm getting up, all of that is my way of letting out what I don't let out every day. All my, negative emotions that I keep inside of me, because I don't want to walk around being negative every day. That's not a way to live life. But if I can muster up all the negative emotions and find a way to let them out in the gym, they're not going to be built up, because I'm letting them out in a way. I'm finding a way to release them and leave them into the world and, all these things. As Tyrone is calling me, see what he has to say. It's Wanna Gang. I'm recording. Want to say what's up to the people?
Oh, it's good, Joe.
All right, I'm in the video. Love you guys. See you guys next time. Peace.
Yeah.